distinguished guests, and ladies and gentlemen. I am delighted to be here, and I'm particularly delighted to be here on this occasion. We meet a city noted for progress, in a state noted for strength. For we meet in an hour of change and challenge, in a decade of hope and fear, in an age of both knowledge and ignorance, the vast stretches of the unknown and the unanswered and the unending, still far outstripped, our collective comprehension. We will have literally reached the stars before midnight tonight. This is a breathtaking pace, and such a pace cannot help but create new ill, as it dispels new ignorance, new problems, new dangers. New ignorance, new problems, new dangers. New ignorance, new ignorance, new problems, new problems, new dangers. Vistas of space promise high costs and hardships as well as high reward. So it is not surprising that some would have us stay where we are. This country of the United States was not built by those who went and rested. This country of the United States was not built by those who went and rested. This country of the United States was not built by those who went and rested.
Not Thank you all for being here tonight. I really appreciate. I'd like to take the moment to introduce the next piece, which I think it deserves. It is taken from a play by Bertolt Brecht, The Life of Galilei. And in six scenes, it is various situations in which Galilei confronts his friends and foes about his revolutionary ideas. It is in French, and you have had the translation, so enjoy.
Ni. Bu. Chat. Votre. Grand. Don. Me. Peu. Sagredo, il n'y aurait donc aucune différence entre la Lune et la Terre. Galilée, il me semble que non. Sagredo, il n'y a pas 10 ans qu'un homme nommé Giordano Bruno a été brûlé à Rome pour avoir tenu la même idée. Galilée, il n'y a pas de doute. Mets tes yeux au-dessus. Ce que tu vois, il n'y a pas de différence entre le ciel et la terre. Aujourd'hui, nous sommes le 10 janvier 1610. L'humanité inscrit dans son journal ciel supprimé. Sagredo. Mais c'est affreux. Galilée. J'ai aussi découvert quelques enters sarti, le curateur. Galilée, je voulais transmettre mes réflexions sur les deux grands systèmes cosmiques à votre cosmos. Ah, oui. Ah, oui. Comment vont vos yeux? Galilée, pas très bien, votre excellence. Si vous permettez, j'ai ici le livre traitant cosmos. L'état de vos yeux me préoccupe. Vraiment, il me préoccupe. Cela prouve que vous employez peut-être avec un peu trop de zèle votre tube renommée. He leaves without taking the book. Galilée. Comment? Il n'a même pas pris le livre. Cosmo, looking at the ladies of the court. The old lady. young lady. Fettuccini. Galilei. The philosopher. The mathematician. Pause. Suddenly, Andrea goes straight to the exit. His mother stops him. His mother. Andrea. He leaves. The philosopher. The marshal. Galilei. Andrea. Galilei. Andrea. Galilei. The window opens and the lady screams.
Sauvez-vous! Chez eux, en face, il y a la peste!
The horrified man runs away. Galilei, avez-vous ma femme de ménage? The lady.
Femme de ménage s'est effondrée dans la rue.
Elle devait le savoir.
C'est pourquoi elle est partie.
She closes the window. Children come out on the street. They see Galilei and run away, screaming. Galilei turns around. At this moment, come out running two soldiers in armor. The soldiers.
Entre dans la maison immédiatement!
With their lances, they push Galilei back into his house. Galilei, by the window.
Mais dis ce qui s'est passé.
The soldiers.
On l'a emmené sur le pré.
The lady appears again at her window. The lady.
Toute la rue, ici derrière, est empestée. Loin de la fermière.
The soldiers close the street with a rope. The lady.
Mais maintenant, personne ne pourra entrer dans notre maison. Vous n'avez pas besoin de fermer ici, ici, comme ça. Halt, halt, écoutez donc. Mon mari est en ville, il ne pourra même plus rentrer. Salon, salon.
We hear from the inside the lady screaming and crying. The soldiers leave.
ce ne sont donc que des constellations. Et où est Dieu alors?
Galilée,
que veux-tu dire par là?
Sagredo.
Dieu. Où est Dieu?
Galilée, very irritated.
Là-haut, sûrement pas. De même, si, là-haut, il y avait des êtres vivants, ils ne trouveraient pas Dieu sur notre terre.
Sagredo.
Mais, où est Dieu, alors?
Galilée, suis-je théologue? Je suis mathématicien. Sagredo.
Avant tout, tu es un homme, et je te demande, est Dieu dans ton système cosmique?
Galilée.
En nous.
Nulle part. Sagredo, furious.
Comme le prétendait l'excommunié.
Galilée.
Comme le prétendait l'excommunié.
Sagredo.
C'est pourquoi on l'a brûlé sur le bûcher il n'y a pas 10 ans de cela.
Thank you.
Before we take on this last piece, I would like to say a few words of thanks. First of all, I'd like to thank my teachers who made this trip to Curtis a very fruitful one, Don Liuzzi, Eric Milstein, and Robert Van Sais. I would I would also like to thank Alexandre for learning this monster. just for the occasion. I would also like to thank all the members of the orchestra for making this night extra special and for playing this piece beautifully, honestly. And again, Don Liuzzi for conducting this piece. Lastly, I want to talk a little bit about this piece. It is called Der Wald. It is German for the forest. It was written in the 80s by Siegfried Matthus, which was an East German composer. And the piece is called The Forest and talks about the decline of the Black Forest in Germany. So it is quite a mournful piece, as you will hear, and it talks about mourning and destruction. And we hope you enjoy.